Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind for the Commodore Amiga. I am Amethyst Lunatari on Morag, about to enter what may just be the final palace, at least it's the final one that we have in any indication here. We're supposed to get 7 crystal strings, and Sabine has 6 of them. So I'm assuming this guy Slorwin has the last crystal string, and then from that we can go back to Lyramion and shatter the glass thing and proceed to what I'm assuming would be the final boss. Again, I'm playing this blind, so I don't really know. That's the way it looks like to me, anyway. I want to identify some of this stuff. Need to get out of that. Do I have to be in camp for that? Wait, I have to be in Valden for that. Yeah, camp. I forgot about this, because I want to identify these shoes. Edgel has 1, right? Leather shoes? Oh, it failed. Ugh. Not magical. So we're dropping these. Oh. I keep thinking I'm in other people's inventory. What the hell? Alright. Leather shoes, done. Keep picking up these Morag darts. I keep holding on to them. Alright, Sabine also has leather shoes. Lightning boots, we know what those do. One of us already has them on, I think. Sorcerer's boots, we've had that. Alright, so I just want to identify Sabine's thing now. Nothing. All right. Oop. All right. So now, I don't like him with such low magic points. Let me just see. I want to make sure he can get off a Show Monster LP, because this is, like, probably the final Morag boss? Or mini-boss, or whatever you want to call it. So, yeah, I am going to rest again. So he's got a bunch of rations. Can he take all of Sabine's rations? No. Can Sabine take his rations? All but 2. I can. Alright, might as well do it that way. So he has 2, and I have the rest. It's really only the 2 of us. And then the rest should have 0. Oh no, she's still... Oh. I thought I took her rations. Wait a second. Oh, never mind then. Oh, that's right, we gave Valden. Never mind then. We end up wasting rations, but we're picking them up now. So, I gotta rest. You gotta wait, and then rest. Good enough. Good enough for Valden. Alright, let's get our protections back on then. Magical barrier. I said magical barrier. Hey! I demand. Alright. magical attack, and anti-magic sphere. Yo, fear. Okay. New save. New episode. Okay. Alright, so we're going right in. Into a battle, that is. CP time for you, up there. Now these things hide in the shadows of the buildings. So we, more often than not, get in a battle and we're coming or going from one of these palaces. And sleep works well on them. I'll just heal that boo-boo. Come on, Valden, not one damage. I keep doing the sleep thing. Okay, so no one's damaged, so. I hope this palace isn't, like, incredibly complicated. It takes us, like, 4 episodes just to get through. This part of the game is kind of a slog, but I do like the flavor text scattered throughout, especially what all the bosses say to you before they attack. For some reason, I just really like that. It's like, I don't know. It's exactly what you'd expect them to say, but I enjoy all that. Mwah, you will go no further. I don't know how you managed to defeat my comrades, blah blah blah. I like it. It's like, it's just classic fantasy stuff to me. Poof! Advance! Alright, since it's sleeping, tends to stay asleep, it probably has a chance to wake up if you're not hitting it, but that chance is, at least for this enemy and the bosses on this world, seem to be rather small. So I'm just gonna get everyone into, or get me into, attack mode. I can actually reach the thing. You know what I'm glad for? No more magical guards. Although, now that I said that, they'll probably be in this castle somewhere. Or palace. Such a fighting dirty I am with all these sleep spells. But they're the most effective at anything. It stops the enemy from attacking, and then we can slice and dice it. And it usually is not resisted. really shouldn't work against the bosses. I don't know why they let sleep work on the bosses. I mean, if it works on the final boss, I don't know if he'd even want to do it that way. I'd want to see what the final boss can do, right? Baldin, level 40. Life points did not go up. 247 power points, 99 spell learning points. That wasn't like that. 228 training points. I think he already had 4 attacks per round. The gold's starting to weigh us down. I'm not even going to take it. Alright, let's go. Already we're seen. Whatever sees me, or sees us, I'd like to see it too. Oh, there you are. Boop. Now 3 Morag dragons. Alright. Sleep for you in the back. They don't seem to advance, really, otherwise an edge could hit them. Bell. 8 damage. Oh, he moved up! He heard me! Now Edgel can slice and dice you. Did it work on this one? I guess so. He would have been hurling spells or something. This will do it on Edgel's. That's hardly anything. Hardly any damage. No. Sleep again. I have a feeling these two in the front will go down relatively around the same time. Even though we have a head start in Edgel, he does more damage. He's got 7 attacks after all. Mudsling! Agile deflected. I don't even know which one cast him. Some good damage there. Edgel killed his first. Oh, come on, guys, catch up. Been moving. There we go. See, I knew there were like gonna be around the same time. Now we can all hit this guy. Feels good, doesn't it? Makes you feel like you're alive for the next minute and a half anyway. Might not even make it that long. No. Oh, did I redirect them? I think I forgot. That's why they're missing. I'm leaving the money. I just can't hold it. Oh! Okay! This battle again. I'm really just doing the same thing, so I think I'm gonna speed up this battle for you guys. If anything interesting happens, I'll clue you in. Okay. Still leaving the money. Any more? We've got two different color walls here. Huh. Alright. Alright, so we've got a door. Apparently just one door. Let's look for any secrets. Interesting how that changes from these moss rocks into more I guess it looks like same color as the sand outside, so maybe more like desert rocks. Have we not heard this theme for a while? I feel like we haven't heard this theme since Lyramion. I could be wrong. We were hearing the other dungeon themes for a while. I don't want to go back outside by mistake. Alright, doesn't seem to be any secrets. Like illusory walls, hidden doors, that kind of thing. Seems like it's just this. Do we need the... I mean, usually don't use it by now, but... the special key? Slowin' key? Okay. Oh, here. More Morag Dragon battles. See, I'll be speeding this one up again. I just keep doing the same thing, really. If it's not broke, don't fix it. Okay. Two ways to go. secret? I mean, that would probably just lead into the other area anyway. Boo! Not seeing anything there. But it looks like... I'm not sure, but we might also access it from that way. The other tunnel. I was gonna look for secrets along this wall. Hidden stuff. Oh, there's a monster saw us for a second. Oh! Where'd you come from? Yeah, over here. You hiding or something? Three more Morag dragons. Rinse, repeat. Getting predictable again. Yeah, these things are no challenge for us. It's just a matter of taking the time to take them out. Okay. Nelvin! Life points did not go up. 753 power points, 262 spell learning points, and 146 training points. Save here. With all the battles we're cutting out, this is gonna last like one episode. Because I don't know how big this is. So this is the room that we came from, right? That's the way the outside. I don't know if there'd be a secret on this wall. But just in case there's a little room with a chest inside. See if we got anything. Check along here, because I don't know if this is as wide as the room on the other side. Oh wait, what am I doing? I got turned around. Wait a second. Okay, I know where we are. I just didn't realize... there was a little niche here. Okay. Alright, there's nothing. Okay, so this is the other side of the corridor. We're looking down. Those dragons came from. Oh, here's a doorway. Oh! Is that the big baddie? The big baddie. I guess we better take care of him. I think I already saved, but... you gotta always save before the boss battle, if at all possible. What do you have to say, Slorwin? The final? Before you stands a mighty Moranian. An unnatural aura surrounds him. He takes his time to examine you carefully, and then he says, "I am Slorwin. I followed your progress with great interest. As you have made it to here, you must be worthy opponents." No one else said that, thank you. "That pleases me because I love a challenge, so let us then decide which world will survive." Then Slorwin attacks you. Attacks me after that? I never thought that would happen. Alright, so we've got two sand lizards and a Slorwin. Let's see if we can put the Slorwin to sleep. See if it works the same as the other bosses. Yeah. He went to sleep. See if he stays asleep until we're ready for him. Whirlwind spell. 32, 20, deflect, deflect, 34, 29. I'm gonna put one of these sand lizards to sleep now as well. That's a mistake in programming or designing, whatever. We should not be able to put bosses to sleep like that so easily. Alright, small heal on Melvin. That one's asleep. The other one's awake and throwing thunderbolts at us. Only Sabine was harmed by that, though. These things, as I remember, have a lot of hit points. 350 or something like that? 320? Something like that. Don't put that one to sleep. Nelvin's fine, Selena's fine, Sabina will heal herself. Well, Sabine, not Selena. We got to the boss quickly. There's no secrets or traps, unless we've yet to see them in this area. I decided not to explore that hallway. So there's that hallway and the room outside. Or the room. That hallway and the room that we're in, actually. Okay, so it looks like Slorwin is still sleeping. The slacker. I'll move me over here. So when we move up. Actually, I'll be in Edgel's way if I do that. I don't want to be in Edgel's way. Check up, I changed places with Valden. The sand lizard sleeping. Who should Sabine heal next? Where's Valden? So we're both moving, we're going in a crisscross pattern. And it's just gonna trade spaces, basically. So now Valden can move up, and I can move up. don't think... Yeah, he'll evolve him next. She should go before him. Okay, we're getting ready for the big guy here. Just in case he wakes up. Actually, Valden can help with that. Also train a little bit. Probably gonna die this round, this thing. There we go. Guy's still sleeping. Okay. Begin the pummeling. May our pummeling be true. Melvin's running out of mana here. One damage. Oh, I want to do another show monster LP. Deep spell. Yeah, I want to see. Oh, I forgot I switched places. We have to see. We have to know. We have to put to sleep. Ah, I failed. We might kill him before we get to see. Depends. Will he make it to the end of the next round? I don't know. Again. It worked this time. If he doesn't die by the end of this round, we can see what his points are. And his total points, of course. But, you know, Edgel's going to town here. So there's no telling. He remains. Wow, 540 points and there's 32 left. Taking no chances, though. Sleep spell. Alright, Valden can join the fight once again. I just do that in case a weapon breaks or something that we need. Wow. 999 gold. 2,000 experience. Agile. Life points did not go up, but 81 training points at 7 attacks per round. He already had 7. Selena. Level 47. No more new life points, but 246 training points. I'm excited, sorry. Sabine. Level 49. Life points didn't go up. Power points 739. Spell learning points 268. Training points are 265. Here's the last crystal string. Sabine has it. So we're trying to identify these boots. I don't really care about the dart and the robe. I left the last robe. we defeated him. Jeez, is that it? I mean, it's the easiest. Then this is the easiest of the palaces. I mean, mind you, I don't know. Slorwyn might have been a tough cookie if we hadn't put him to sleep every round. He didn't even get to do anything. It's looking to see if there's any hidden stuff. With like a chest behind it. Goodies. Anything like that. This just goes out to the corridor. Yeah, I'm not seeing anything here. Maybe he was just so tough. If you didn't use sleep, that they really thought it was hard enough. I don't know. Well, this goes even more. Oh, it's just dead end. I think we... Did we look here? I think so. Let's check this wall here. I didn't want to do it with him standing there. You know, he seemed to just be waiting for us. Nothing, huh? So the palaces get more straightforward as you continue on. The last two are really pretty easy, pretty simple construction. I'm heading east. South is the way out, so I think this is where we want to be going. Yeah. Okay. Well, yeah, back to the village. But I want to be ready for anything. What if we're ambushed at the village or something? He does need one of them, but Novin's... Oh. Took all... Doesn't seem to make a difference. I'm just trying to... Let's just drop some gold. I hate to do it, but I need to be able to give him rations. Oop. I'm rationalizing the rations. Okay, two. Okay, so you have a lot. Zero, zero. Two, a lot, and a bunch. He only needs one. See if anyone can take these four. Okay. How much time do we spend in that palace? So he needs another one. I need another one, which is fine. I don't think anyone can take hers. Nope, alright. So we're gonna waste a ration, that's fine. We've been picking them up, we haven't been running out of them or buying any of them. Magic. Alright, so we need to head back. We've got all the crystal strings now. We need 7 of them. And we have them. So, wondering about the harp. Hold on. I don't want to screw anything up. How do we attach them, right? I don't even know who has the harp. Gotta be Valden then. Okay, here it is. Elf harp. She can carry it. I mean, I wonder if someone has to put this on for us, or this is something we can do. Okay, it's back into where you can play the songs. Cannot be used here. We might have to go back to Lyramion. I don't know, maybe we have to repair it that way. There's someone in the village who repairs stuff. Maybe they can do that. Anyway, so we need to head back to the village. Which is at 22133 village. And that'll be next episode. Maybe they can fix our harp. Or maybe we have to go back to Lyramion. Maybe it's something we do ourselves, or maybe we have to go back to the harp. The guy who sold us the harp. Possible. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.